Thank you. Good evening, Queens College. How's everyone doing? Jason Hootie back here with another 60 and 60 trivia game show. Tonight we are doing Women's History Month edition. Thanks so much for being here. Let's get things started, shall we? If you have not already done so, on your phone, head on over to crowd.live/QueensMarch3. I will put that into the YouTube comments one more time. crowd.live/QueensMarch3. That's where you want to head to. Best way to do things is to be watching this YouTube live stream on a computer or a tablet, and then on your phone. Or if you prefer, you can split the screen on your computer. Head on over to crowd.live/QueensMarch3. So you'll be having two things open, the YouTube live stream and then the crowd.live to answer the questions. Once you are there, enter your name and your email address. This information will only be used if you win a prize, so please enter it accurately. Once you've done all that, you should end up at a screen that looks like this. If you have not already done this, you can use the camera app on your phone to scan the QR code in the bottom left-hand corner. That'll also take you to the same place. If at any point it asks you for a code, QueensMarch3 is the code. Got it? Cool. Well, once we get started, we will have 60 questions for you in 60 minutes. Answer the questions quickly and correctly to score more points. At the end of the show, the top three players each win a $60 Amazon gift card, hence the name of the show, 60 and 60. $60 in 60 minutes. Two other mystery players will split another $60, $30 each, for a total gift card giveaway this evening of $240. Now, if you have any technical issues with the questions not appearing on your phone, best thing to do is just try refreshing your browser. If that problem persists, we have found sometimes it's broadband cellular data, not Wi-Fi. Usually it doesn't happen. Now, if our system crashes, I will be back. There's a lot of technology going on this side of the screen between YouTube and the software to stream and the software to change the scenes and software to play the game. Just a lot going on. So if your YouTube starts to go blank or it says that it's missing or buffering, most likely it's dropped on my end. Just talk amongst yourselves for a few minutes on YouTube and then I will get things back up and running. It usually doesn't happen. Just want to make you aware of it though in case it does. Now the questions will appear on your phone 3 to 5 seconds before they appear on YouTube. It's just the delay in the two softwares that we have to use. If that delay does start to increase where it's like 8 to 12 seconds long, simply refresh your YouTube browser and you'll be good to go. I will ask you to do that every couple of questions. Every 15 questions we'll all refresh as a group. Right now we have got Shira, Felicia, Natalie, Yunso, welcome back, Elizabeth, Sadie Ann, welcome back as well, Jessica, I don't think those were our three winners last time, right? Shayla, Gabrielle, Erica, Stephanie, another Jessica, Valerie, I like the way you spell your name, that's nice, Carly, Shayna, Moisley, I hope I'm saying that right, Jonathan, Bunny, another Shayla, and Aaron and Melissa. So if I did not read your name, you are not currently in the game. Just drop something into the YouTube stream, let me know, say hey, you didn't read my name, and I will do my best to get you logged in. In addition, tonight not only are we playing our normal show, we are also playing the Nationals edition. What that means is tonight, if you end up in first, second, or third place, you will get $60 for your efforts. But more than that, you will also be invited to play the 60 and 60 Nationals, which happens at the end of next month, Wednesday, April 28th, 8 p.m. Eastern Time. Tonight we give away $240 on Wednesday, April 28th. You will be competing against schools across the country who have played the 60 and 60 game. Last night it was a school in Louisiana, and the night before that I believe it was Indiana, and then three of you will be joining us from the last time that we played. Anyways, that night we will have $2,000 in prize money, $1,000 for first place, $500 for second, $250 for third, $550 random money giveaways, a whole bunch of cash, and three of you will be eligible to join us if you end up in first, second, or third place tonight. Most of the show will look like this. I'll be up here in the corner. Hi, everyone. All the action will be taking place on that side of the screen, and you'll be answering right on your phone, or if you've split your screen, you'll be answering not in YouTube, but on the other side of things. Be sure to feel free to use the YouTube comments throughout the show if you want to gloat that you're in first place or cry that you're in last place or just talk and make some comments about any of the questions. The YouTube live stream is the place to do it. Also, with any technical issues, that is the place to go. I think that we're good. Enough of my jabbering. Let's get things started. You will see the countdown begin on your phone and also on the YouTube screen. Once we get things started here and down to zero, we will be off and running. Let's get going with our first question. Before becoming a superstar, Beyoncé was a member of what female group? You see that up at the top, and then below there it says answer options will reveal once question is activated. I did that on my side, and I'll do that right now. Was it Destiny's Child, TLC, Spice Girls, or Pussycat Dolls? We're going to start things off super simple and then work our way up in difficulty during our 60 minutes together. All you have to do is press A, B, C, or D on your phone. That'll lock in your answer, and hopefully you'll be right. After the time has expired for each question, we will head on over to the live answers, which shows how all of you are voting right now in real time. 19 of you! There's 24 of you logged into play, so if anybody's having problems out there, let me know. But 19 of you have answered for Destiny's Child. 100%. And 100% of you are correct. Destiny's Child is the correct answer. Nicely done. And then after each question, we'll have a fun fact like this one. Destiny's Child was formed in Houston in 1990. Every five questions, we'll take a look at the leaderboard. Right now, Felicia's in first place, having gotten the question correct, as is Elizabeth and Stephanie. All of you actually scored 96 points, answering at the same moment, apparently. And then you can see on down the line. We'll check this every five questions or so. JC saying hi to everyone on YouTube. Welcome, JC. Don't see any other questions or comments happening on YouTube, so it must mean you understand how to play. Let's get moving. Question two. Known for her unbelievable humanitarian work, she ranked first in Gallup's list of most widely admired people of the 20th century. Eleanor Roosevelt, Mother Teresa, Sister Mary Robert, Laura Bush. For each question, you have 20 seconds to answer. As you can see, once I activate those answers, the time and the point value begin to tick on down. So the faster you answer, the more points you get. However, make sure you answer correctly, because if you don't answer correctly, it doesn't matter how fast you answer, you're not going to get points for an incorrect answer. Ooh, a tough one right off the start there. Very interesting. With the correct answer still being the majority of you, 55% of you going with Mother Teresa. Mother Teresa, number one most admired person of the entire 20th century. Yeah, and a Nobel Peace Prize winner in 1979. Question number three. Having lost her sight and hearing as a baby, she went on to become an American author and disability advocate. Helen Keller, Sudha Chandran, Patty Duke, Laura Bridgman. Those are your four choices for this question. Lock in your answers A, B, C, or D for this first set of questions. Questions are worth 100 points each. As the game continues, the point value will increase, as supposedly will the difficulty in the questions. 100% of you, 21 of you getting answered in now. Helen Keller is correct. Nicely done. But this is fascinating. By the age of 7, Helen Keller could distinguish people by the vibrations of their footsteps. That's a great fact about Helen Keller, therefore. She is widely considered responsible for creating the American flag. Do you know this one? It's Martha Washington, Abigail Adams, Molly Pitcher, or Betsy Ross. Those are your four choices, A, B, C, or D. Still in the easier set of questions here. Feel free to use YouTube if you want to reach out and say anything like, hey, I've seen the American flag. If so, tell me where you seen it, where you saw it at. 86% of you are going with the correct answer. Betsy Ross. Betsy Ross is the correct answer. If you don't know where the American flag is, the original one is in the Smithsonian in Washington, D.C. Has anybody seen it? If so, put it on YouTube. It's like in this really dark room with like blue lights to preserve it. It's kind of cool. Number five. Which movie was Jennifer Lawrence not in? Has been in three of these, has not been in one. You tell me which one she was not in. Between Hunger Games, American Hustle, Easy A, or Silver Linings Playbook. I have not seen all of these. I probably would have gotten it right. And let's see if you did. That's a pretty high majority. 80% of you going with Easy A. A vote for each one of those, even Hunger Games. Very interesting. Easy A is the correct answer. Easy A was Emma Stone. And Jennifer Lawrence has a foundation that empowers children in the arts. We are five questions in. Every five questions, we check the leaderboard, which shows us that Stephanie is currently in first place, getting all five questions right, as have a bunch of you at the moment. Felicia in second, Valerie in third place, Melissa, Shayla, Sadie Ann, That's how everyone else is stacking, and there's on the second sheet. All of you have a chance to work your way up onto the leaderboard as well. Question number six. Question number six is Florence Nightingale, an influential woman. In what field? Is it writing, mathematics, nursing, or astronomy? Nothing's going on YouTube. Kind of quiet tonight on YouTube. Usually Queens is kind of chatty up there. Well, we'll see if you add to it throughout our 60 minutes together. Time is ticking on down. We'll see how much do you know about Florence Nightingale? Pretty much a lot. At least three quarters of you do. Going with nursing. Once again, a vote for every one of those answers, but not nearly as many as the correct answer, which is nursing. She was also a statistician. That's a hard word for me to say. Statistician. Struggling with that one. She founded the science of radioactivity, and her discoveries have led to effective treatments for cancer. Ada Lovelace, Marie Curie, Rosalind Franklin, Rachel Carson. Statistician. You know what else, another word I struggle with is nativity. You know, that the thing that everyone puts up at Christmas with Mary and Joseph and Jesus. I always called it the nativity, always putting the emphasis on the wrong syllable. Whatever. Nativity. It took me a long time to get that one right. It did not take a long time for 90% of you to get Marie Curie right, however, as that is the correct answer. She was a daughter of a secondary school teacher. Somehow she ended up founding the science of radioactivity. Question number eight. The founder of the American Red Cross was, speaking of founders, one of those four. Dwayne says they are focused on winning. Yes, probably true. It's kind of tough, actually. I've played the game from your side before. It's tough to make YouTube comments while you're also trying to answer the questions, so. But if you feel like talking, I'll read off some of your YouTube comments. It's always fun. Is this going to be a well-scored answer? It is, because it's 90% of you going with Miss Clara Barton, who is the correct answer, risked her life to bring supplies to Civil War soldiers, and then founded the American Red Cross. How about that? Question number nine. This African-American woman refused to give up her seat in Montgomery, Alabama. Now, if you were with us last month for Black History Month, this is the one question that is kind of recycled. It's an easy one anyway. That's why we kept it in the first 10 section. Because people probably know it, especially if you joined us last month, like Jessica and Sadie Ann and a bunch of you did. It's 100%. 100% going for Rosa Parks, which is the correct answer. Rosa Parks, an activist her whole life, became the recording secretary for the NAACP about 15 years before refusing to give up her seat on that bus. Question number 10. Before becoming the first female vice president, Kamala Harris was attorney general for what state? This is Women's History, which goes perfectly for Women's History Month, March. And this show's going to be about pop culture and science and civil rights and history and medicine and basically spanning all sorts of endeavors and significant women contributions to our life, including this one. Is it going to be good? It is. I mean, it's pretty recent, right? We all heard a bunch about it, and 95% of you, one person went with Washington. 95% of you went with the correct answer. I did not know that Kamala Harris's mother was a biomedical scientist. 10 questions in. Stephanie, Felicia, there's Sadie Ann, up where she normally is, in the top three. Not bad, everybody. At least to get things started tomorrow. Welcome to the show. Thanks for joining us. 22 of you playing now. Yoon-Soo coming right on up as well. Let's continue forward, my friends, to question number 11. Who is author Mary Shelley's famous monster? Did she create Dracula, Frankenstein, the Wolfman, or Godzilla? This set of questions, 11 through 20 questions, are now worth 200 points each. So if you start off a little bit slow, you got time to make up some ground. If you're up at the top, try to put some distance between yourself and the competition. Usually this comes down to a vote between A and B. Let's see if that's the case today. Not really, because the overwhelming majority of you went with Frankenstein, which is the correct. Nicely done! Not bad at all. Wow, usually that's like 60-40 or 70-34 Frankenstein, but you're ahead of the curve. Question number 12. One of the most popular singers of this century, which song below is not from Taylor Swift? Shake It Off. 15. How Do I Live? Our Song. Shake It Off. Shake It Off. Shake It Off. I love that song. That is such a fun song. Alrighty, we're coming up on a quarter point of the show. Time is flying on by. Put in your answer. Is it not a huge majority? Two-thirds of you going for C, one-third of you going for B. One of those answers is correct. How Do I Live is not Taylor, it's Leanne Rimes. Hey, that wasn't bad. I give myself credit for that one. Grew up in Reading, Pennsylvania, moved to Nashville to pursue country music, and I'd say that she ended up doing okay with it. Question number 13. Considered the greatest female soccer player of all time, she was on the U.S. national team for 17 years, won gold medals. Christine Lilly, Christine Sinclair, Abby Wambach, Mia Hamm. I think there will be three or four sports questions in our show. This one, surprisingly, is not always scored that great. Yeah, I thought more people would know it. Let's see how you did. I never know how you do until I hit this button. And as has been the trend so far, it's early in the month, but Mia Hamm, little majority, but Mia Hamm is the correct answer. She was born with a club foot, wore corrective shoes as a toddler, went on to become the greatest female soccer player of all time. 14. 14. Sacagawea was a Native American woman who helped whom in their expedition? I think that should be who helped whom, or is it who helped who? If you, there's any English lit majors out there or writing majors, let me know. Journalism majors, maybe any of you can say, hey, it should be who helped who or who helped whom. I would appreciate the input as our time runs down. And Christopher Columbus is incorrect. Lewis and Clark is indeed correct. Nicely done. Sacagawea grew up in modern-day Idaho. That's kind of where Lewis and Clark went, discovering the Wild West. Sacagawea helped him. I even heard that she gave birth while on the trail. Crazy. 15. Coco Chanel, the iconic fashionista, has which signature scent? Is it Chanel number 3, Chanel number 5, Chanel number 7, Love Potion number 9? And does anyone wear this? I had a girl last night who says that her mom calls it old people perfume. And 71% of you going with the answer of B, Chanel number 5, which is the correct answer. She is the only fashion designer listed on Time Magazine's list of the 100 most influential people of the 20th century. That's quite a list to be on. Checking out our leaderboard, and it is Felicia, Stephanie, and Shayna now. 1, 2, and 3. Okay, I gotta slow down. I just found out that we can do this, so I'm gonna hit this button, I'm gonna hit this button. Sadie Ann, Moisley, Shira, Melissa, Valerie had a little bit of a fall, as did Yun Su. Ooh, tough go for those ones there. Bunny is there in 12th place. And here's how page 2 looks. All right, everyone's still in the game. Hey, while we go through this, why does everyone go ahead and refresh your YouTube browser? Just hit that refresh or that reload button now that we're 15 questions in. That'll just make sure that you are up to speed and in sync as much as possible. Have you done it? I've done it on my end. Hopefully you've done it by now. So let's go to number 16. This prohibits sex-based discrimination in any school or other educational program that receives federal money. I'm not going to read this one because that way you can figure out. Not only do you have to know which program it is, but you have to know a little bit of your Roman numerals. What is VIIRXI? The only reason I really know Roman numerals is the Super Bowl, but... Two-thirds of you going with Title IX, otherwise known as Title IX, also known as the correct answer. Title IX is the correct answer, passed less than 50 years ago. in 1972. Estee Lauder is synonymous with what industry? Cosmetics, pediatrics, movie director, deep sea expeditions. A, B, C, or D are your options. Go ahead and put in the one that you believe is correct as we are approaching the third point, one third point of the way of the show. After question 30, I'll show you how the random money giveaway works, even if you're not doing that great. Cosmetics, everybody except for one of you. And cosmetics is the correct answer. Cosmetics for the win. Her interest came from her uncle's skin cream creations. I want to hear more about that story. What were his skin cream creations? Take a look at that gif. Who is this famous fictional female? This is one of my favorite facts or stories, whatever you want to call it, about this show. If you haven't noticed, each one of these questions comes with a gif that'll hopefully make you chuckle or smile. That's the point of everything. Sally the Sailor, Patty the Pilot, Carrie the Contractor, Rosie the Riveter. Those are your four choices. Let's see what you said. 3/4 of you went with the correct answer, although there were votes for every one of those answers. Rosie the Riveter, based on real American women who found factory work during World War II, producing war supplies and other munitions, including aircraft. So the women, I mean, they were just as instrumental in World War II because they supplied everything that went out. Rosie the Riveters. 19. As one of the first leaders for women's rights, who was the first woman pictured on a U.S. coin in circulation? Lucy Stone, Melinda Gates, Matilda Gage, Susan B. Anthony. By the way, I did mention that questions are currently worth 200 points each. They're about to go up. So if you're a little bit behind, chance to make up some ground. Okie dokie. 90% of you going with Susan B. Anthony. Oh yeah, that's a big score. Susan B. Anthony collected anti-slavery petitions when she was super young. I don't use the gold coins. Does anybody out there use the gold coins, the Susan B. Anthony coin? Yeah, let me know on YouTube if you do. Let's go to question 20. Which below is not a song from Lady Gaga? Thank You, Next, Rain on Me, Million Reasons, or Just Dance? Those are your four options. Go ahead and put in the answer that you believe to be correct, as our time is running down on question number 20. Let's see what you think. Hey, that's a pretty high score. 80% of you going for Thank You, Next, Ariana Grande. It's not my favorite song, but Lady Gaga, Born This Way, I think that's my favorite Lady Gaga song. 20 questions in, and it's Felicia holding on to this top spot. Stephanie is still in number 2, and Shayna is in 3rd. It has stayed that way now for a couple of rotations. However, it's a pretty close game, especially as point values are about to go up, which means that a lot could happen. Valerie's making her way back on up. Oh no, Yunsoo falling a little bit. Okay. Tamara's worked up in the 21st place. Excellent. Okay, let's move on forward to our next set of questions. It starts with question number 21. This well-known woman of the Wild West was Calamity. Was it Calamity Sue, Calamity Joyce, Calamity Jane, Calamity Joy? A, B, C, or D, those are your four choices. This set of questions, 21 through 30, they are now worth 300 points each. So if you're a little bit behind, it's a chance for you to make up some ground. You voted like this, with Calamity Jane taking 71% of your votes. And Calamity Jane is indeed the correct answer. 71% of you going for Calamity Jane. I didn't know that there was a Calamity Jane documentary released in 2014. I'm gonna have to check that out. Sounds kind of interesting. I don't know much about Calamity Jane. Question number 22 is going to ask you, what year did American women gain the right to vote? Was it 1900, 1920, 1940, or 1960? Go ahead and put in your choices. Well, maybe not choices, but just one choice. Just one choice will probably be the right answer. If you put in choices, software doesn't give you options to do that. Nothing happened on YouTube. You're all concentrating, focused on winning. Yeah, good job. Last year, of course, was the 100th year anniversary. If you do your math correctly, that means 1920. 1920 is when it happened, despite the passage of the amendment and the decade-long contribution of black women to achieve suffrage. Poll taxes, local laws, other restrictions continued to block women of color from voting. 23. Which movie was Anne Hathaway not in? Was in 3, was not in 1. Is it The Girl on the Train, Ocean's 8, The Devil Wears Prada, or The Dark Knight Rises? This question can sometimes be tricky, usually about 3/4 to 1/4. We'll see though. It's weird how every single show is always different. Let's see what you think. And this is unusual. Usually 3/4 of people vote for The Girl on the Train. 1/4 vote for The Dark Knight Rises. 1/4 did vote for The Dark Knight Rises, but there were a whole bunch of people who did not vote for The Girl on the Train, which is the correct answer. Anne Hathaway. I like Anne Hathaway. One of the highest paid actresses in the world. She's cool. 24. She was the first female U.S. astronaut. Christina Koch, Annie McLean, Sally Ride, Peggy Wilson. Those are your choices for A, B, C, or D for question number 24. After the next question, you know what time it is? It's time to check out the leaderboard. We'll do it after the next question. They're currently worth 300 points each. And is it Sally Ride? It is indeed Sally Ride. You're kind of on fire. You're doing really good. I think so far it's been the majority of you have gotten every single question correct. That's what we like to see. 25. It has always been a huge majority, but it's been a majority. The cultural icon, Marilyn Monroe, saying happy birthday to which presidents? Dwight Eisenhower, Richard Nixon, Gerald Ford, John F. Kennedy. I'm going to take a sip of water as you answer this question. And I'm back. And you're thinking like this. You're thinking, yeah, those would be the two to go to. And 80% of you went with the correct answer. John F. Kennedy. John F. Kennedy. Marilyn Monroe won a Golden Globe in 1960. It is Felicia, Stephanie, and now Melissa is up in the top. That is correct. Erica is in fourth place. Sadie Ann. Valerie, you kind of making a move. Look at that. Valerie and Moisey. Are tied exactly 29-20. That's pretty good this far in the show to be exactly tied. Hold on. We gotta go and look at the next page. There's the next page. I mean, a bunch of you still have 18 out of 25, 17 out of 25 correct. You're not doing too bad. Just not quite there yet. Oh, Bunny moved up into 10th place. All right, let's move forward to 26. We're getting to the halfway point. It's going to get a little bit more interesting. Who is this cook mastering the art of French cooking? Perhaps the original chef, female chef. Rachel Ray, Julia Child, Claire Smith, Alice Water. Those are the four choices. Put down the answer. I would have gotten this one. It's not always hugely answered correctly, but yeah, we'll see. We'll see what you think as time's running on down. And that's what we call an overwhelming majority. Anytime it's over 80-85%, that's a majority. And Julia Child is the correct answer. 1963 is when she premiered on television. The original female chef. 27. This transcendent woman author wrote Pride and Prejudice. You know, we were assigned to read Pride and Prejudice in high school. I didn't make it through the book. I know it's one of the great American novels. Someone put out there on YouTube, did you read Pride and Prejudice? What did you think? I had to kind of fudge a little bit on the test for it, because I definitely didn't finish that book. But everybody knows the author is Jane Austen, and Jane Austen is the correct answer. She completed the initial draft at age 21. Remarkable. 28. 28 is going to ask you about Lucille Ball. One of the best known female comedians. What is her trademark hair color? Is it blonde, red, brunette, or gray? Ashni, what you want to do is head to crowd.live/queensmarch3. So, Ashni, head in. So what you want to do is be watching this YouTube live stream on a computer or tablet on your phone. Type that in, crowd.live/queensmarch3. Once you're there, put in your name and your email address, and that's where you answer the questions. That way they register as points, okay? So go ahead and register. You're halfway through the show, but you still have a chance to win some money and have a good time for the next 30 minutes. Red, three quarters of you are correct. It is red. Famous for I Love Lucy, Lucille Ball was the first female inductee into the Television Academy's Hall of Fame. I mean, she broke a lot of barriers for women on television. 29. Sandra Bullock represents which state in Miss Congeniality? Oh, this is a good movie. I love this movie. It is so fun. Okay. Well, I believe that this is a first in the show. You're on? Perfect. Thanks for letting me know that you're on. Awesome. I believe that this is a first for the show because it is the first time that the majority of you are incorrect. That always causes a shakeup in the leaderboard. 32% of you, 70 of you went with New Jersey. That is the state that Sandra Bullock represents. Her big break came in 1990. I haven't watched Speed in a long time. I gotta go back and watch it. Ooh, that, we'll see what happens. Question number 30. This is the halfway point of the show. The mother of American modernism. She was known for painting all that stuff you see on your screen. Not the GIF. Who was she? Those are your four options. I'm going to get everything set because after this, we have a whole bunch to take care of as we're at the halfway point of the show. And, oh, we have 29 of you registered. So a whole bunch are registered that aren't currently playing. Interesting. Interesting. Oh, we're done. And it's a three-quarter vote. Three quarters going for Georgia. O'Keefe. There's a museum in Santa Fe, New Mexico. Pretty cool if they have some of the paintings there. Maybe one day. We see Stephanie is in first. Felicia is in second. Sadie Ann is in third. Well, well, well. Now it's starting to get a little bit interesting. Erica is now in fourth place. Moisey moving up, as is Valerie. Look at this, Melissa. This is good. And then on the second page, it's showing us Shira and Shayla. Back to back, Gabriel, Aaron, Carly. All right. And then down there on the next screen, couple new people. Ingrid, welcome as well. Thanks for being here. Ashley, you can actually win some money. Hey, if you have not done so recently, everyone go ahead and refresh that YouTube browser. Hit that refresh or that reload button. That'll get you up in sync as much as possible. Let me show you at the end of the show. We pull up the trusty Google random number generator. I'll put a minimum number of 4 in there because first, second, and third place have already won their money. They're not eligible for the random money giveaway. I'll put a maximum number of 24 or however many people are playing at the end of the show. And then all we'll do is we'll generate a couple of numbers. And two of you will win money just like that for hanging out with us for a little bit, having a good time. You'll walk away with $30. You can't beat that, right? That'll happen at the end of the show. We'll see what place you are in. But for now, we continue forward with the second half, beginning with question 31. Adele sung the main theme song for which James Bond movie? Spectre, Casino Royale, Skyfall, Die Another Day. I think there's a new James Bond movie in the can. Maybe it was supposed to come out last year and didn't because of the virus. But I think there's another one also. It might actually be, what's his name's last one? Roger Craig isn't right. I can't remember. I'm drawing a blank on it. But 95% of you are not drawing a blank on Skyfall being the song that Adele sung and the movie that she did. 15 Grammys for Adele. Incredible. 32 is gonna ask you. She was the first female to be the United States Attorney General serving during the Clinton administration. Questions are getting tougher, my friends. Let's see if anything's happening on YouTube. Nothing's happening on YouTube. All right. And here's what you thought. How did voting look for it? Not bad, not bad. Two-thirds of you going with Janet Reno. Janet Reno being the correct answer. Spent her early days in office advocating for the increase in protection for women speaking abortions. Then she was the first female U.S. Attorney General. 33. Anne Yokley was an American sharpshooter who starred in Blank's Wild West Show, Pat Boone's Booger Reds, Texas Jack's Buffalo Bills, Wild West Show. This set of questions, 31 through 40. Questions are now worth 400 points apiece. All you have to do is get on a little bit of run. You can still end up in the money positions. We'll check it again after 35 and see what's happening. Texas Jack got some votes. Buffalo Bill got a lot more votes because that is the correct answer. Buffalo Bill's Wild West Show. At 15, Annie Oakley won a shooting contest against experienced marksman, whom she later married. There you go, 34. I'm not really sure what else to say about that one. Harriet Beecher Stowe enlightened the world into the harsh realities of slavery with Uncle Blank's Cabin. Uncle Grant's, Uncle Tom's, Uncle Joseph's, Uncle Roy's. I could not find any gif for Harriet Beecher Stowe except for this one. I don't know why something of hers is on sale and then the sale tag gets clipped off. It was the only gif that featured Harriet Beecher Stowe. So that's the one I went with. It's everybody. Everybody who answered went with Uncle Tom's Cabin, and everybody who answered is correct. When Uncle Tom's Cabin was published, it became a turning point in the abolitionist movement. 35. This Latina artist is known as the pop superstar who brought Mexica Tejano music to the masses. I am sorry for my terrible speaking pronunciation. Mexica Tejano? I'm going with that. This question is tough. I'll tell you that the answer is Selena Quintanilla. Do you know how it was spelled? 57% of you believe that you do, and 57% of you are right! Nicely done! That is the way to spell Selena's name. Won a Grammy, gold record, pop superstar, brought Mexica Tejano music to the masses. It is Stephanie in first place at 6,700. A nice, healthy lead over Felicia. Well, I mean, it's over a question, so that's a healthy lead at this point. Sabian is up there as well. Moisey just knocking outside. Moisey, let me know on YouTube if I'm saying your name incorrectly. Just kind of phonetically spell it for me. Melissa, Erica's now down there in sixth place. Valerie has been up and down, and now, yeah, all right. Question number 36. She was Britain's first female prime minister. Was it Theresa May, Golda Meir, Margaret Thatcher, Agatha Barbara? Anything happen on YouTube? No one's talking on YouTube, so I'll just talk to you instead. Put in your answer for 36. 400 points are on the line. What are you going to choose? Let's see what it was. It was 80% of you going with Margaret Thatcher. Good job, Margaret Thatcher. Correct answer. She was nicknamed the Iron Lady because of her tough leadership style. Iron Lady, 37. The Iron Lady. Jane Goodall is the world's best-known anthropologist, mostly known with her work for with which primate? I mean, I know that she was involved with monkeys, but to actually know the primate, that's a tough one. This is a documentary I would watch. I'm sure there's got to be some Jane Goodall stuff out there, but I would want to see. I think that would be very interesting to see the work that she has done. Hey, 3/4 of you are smarter than I am because you went with chimpanzee. I don't know if I would have gotten that one right. Yeah. At the age of 26 is when Jane Goodall traveled to Tanzania to discover the world of wild chimpanzees. Her life's work. 38. What was Ruth Bader Ginsburg's
nickname?
Darth Vader, the notorious RBG, Puff Ginzy, Baby Ruth. A, B, C, or D, as we're coming on down. To the next set of questions. Point values are about to go up again. And 87% of you know this one for sure. That the notorious RB. What a great nickname. What a great nickname. The notorious RB. I want a cool nickname like that. 39. In 1973, this woman tennis player defeated male Bobby Riggs in the Battle of the Sexes tennis match. Billie Jean King, Lana Kloss, Margaret Court, Steffi Graf. This is one of my favorite gifts of the show. It's a Nintendo Wii. I don't know if they sped this up or what they did, but it makes me laugh every time I look at it. Every time I look at it, it makes me laugh. Oh boy, oh boy. Okay. Your thinking went like this. Yeah, that's a whole bunch of you. Margaret Court got all the other votes. If you don't know the story, there's a movie that came out in 2017 called Battle of the Sexes. It's a pretty good watch. And number 40, then we'll check out the leaderboard. This trans woman was a pioneering LGBT activist who fought tirelessly for trans rights. Sylvia Hernandez, Sylvia Gonzalez, Sylvia Castillo, Sylvia Rivera. I'll give you a hint. Her first name was Sylvia. You can have that hint. You're welcome. And time's ticking on down. And Tom is up. Well, well, well. I mean, it's not 50% of you, but it is the majority of people who answered. Went with the correct answer, Sylvia Rivera, often credited with putting the T in LGBT. We are 40 questions in, and it is Stephanie, Felicia, and Sadie Ann holding on to first, second, and third. However, look at that. There is now a battle for first, as the two of you are, what, 30 points apart? Sadie Ann? Well, Sadie Ann, you're only one question out of being up there. And Moisey, you're only one question out of taking over Sadie Ann. Erica, you're not that far behind. What's going on page two over here? You and Sue are starting to make a move up there again. As is Valerie. Here's page two. Anything interesting happening? Ashley, not doing bad down there. For when you started, Ashley, not bad at all. Excellent. Cool, cool, cool. Okay, we're moving on forward to question number 41. This set of questions gets difficult. Which female has sold the most books all time? This set of questions from like 41 through 45 usually it changes the game a little bit. We'll see how it happens today. It's always different. You never quite know. This one usually comes down to a vote between two, B and C. The question is which one is correct. And everything came down between B and C. The correct answer is C. C and Agatha Christie. 39% of you again. J.K. Rowling is a great guess. Her books have sold 500 million, which is the most for a single book series. Agatha Christie has sold four times as many books, over 2 billion. Just not as a single series. Like, yeah. 42. Which one of these females was not a cast member on Saturday Night Live? Three were, one was not. Who was not? This set of questions, 41 through 50, they're currently worth 500 points apiece. This is gonna be something. Time's ticking on down. Put in your best guess. If you have to take a guess, maybe you know it. Well, it is B or D. One of those answers is correct. It's D. It's Amy Schumer. 35% of you going with Amy Schumer. Has not been a cast member, but has hosted twice. 43. Having written 1,775 poems, she is often considered one of the most important figures in American poetry. This one's decently scored, usually. Gabby, foul play. I'm not sure. Oh, that is a tough one. Tanver, so what you want to do is head to crowd.live/QueensMarch3. So, Tanver, what you want to do is be watching this YouTube live stream, and then what I just gave you, that link there on your phone, head to crowd.live/QueensMarch3. Put in your name and your email address there, and that's where you'll be answering right on your phone, and that way it activates your points, okay? Let me know when you're on, and we'll get you in for the last quarter of the game. Is it Emily Dickinson? It most certainly is. 65% of you getting the correct answer. She attended Amherst Academy. One of the most important figures in American poetry. 44. This Latina woman is the first to win a Lifetime Achievement Grammy. I would have been completely guessing on this one. Good luck to you. Maybe you'll know better than I do, but I would have been not even being able to make an educated guess. I would have just been making a straight up guess. Time's ticking on down, and you're thinking like this. Ooh, boy. Oh, it's all changing right up there to the last moment. 9 of you went with C, and 9 of you get some points. Nicely done, Maria Elena Salinas, longest-running female news anchor on U.S. television. Crazy, right? 45, three-quarters of the way through the show. Who was the first U.S. Secretary of State female? Condoleezza Rice, Madeleine Albright, Hillary Clinton, Kamala Harris. We will check out the leaderboard after this question. Madeleine Albright, okay. Yeah, Madeleine Albright is correct. B being the correct answer. All right, everyone, go ahead and please refresh your YouTube browser. I'm actually going to do the same thing on my side. Just going to hit that refresh button. That'll just keep us all in sync as much as possible. Hopefully the lag time's not doing too bad. Now that I've done that, let's head on over and take a look at the leaderboard. Felicia is in first place. Stephanie is in second place, but only 50 points separate the two of you. Moisey has cracked into the money positions. And now trying to get up a little bit higher. Sadie Ann, Erica, you were there for a while, working your way back up. Yunsu, making a late push on over here. Well, this is something. This is getting exciting, everybody. Oh, this is exciting. Even if you're not near the top, don't worry, because you can still win money with the random money giveaway, which will be happening in not too long of a time. Tanvir, you're in the game. Excellent. Glad to see it. Let's go to 46. Anne Frank wrote her famous diary while hiding during what war? This is 500 points if you get it. 500 points for a question about Anne Frank. Let's see if anything's going on YouTube. Nothing's happening on YouTube. That means everyone is doing stellar right where you're at. This is a nice competitive game. I like where things are headed. And all right, maybe that's almost a unanimous. One person went differently, but everybody else, she hit for 706. Oh, such a tragic story. 47. All of these women won gold in ice skating at the Olympics except for one. Who did not win gold? Michelle Kwan, Sarah Hughes, Christy Yamaguchi, Tara Lipinski. Who did not win gold? Well, for the first time in the show, the lowest answer with 17% of the votes is correct. Michelle Kwan. Can you believe it? Michelle Kwan, she won a silver and a bronze, perhaps the most accomplished ice skater of her time, if not ever, and yet did not win a gold medal. And Olympic or figure skating was the only women's category in 1924. 48. That was usually always a tough question. She is the best-selling female singer of all time, having sold over 200 million albums. I am not sure why there's a gif of a jet plane. I think I may have made a mistake. because I must have pressed the wrong GIF. That's funny. All right. A or B. And one of those is correct. It is Madonna. If you went with A, 52% of you got the correct answer. Madonna, 200 million albums, nominated for 28 Grammy Awards. Incredible. 449. 49 says, who is the first Latina Supreme Court justice in U.S. history? Sonia Watson, Sonia Sanchez, Sonia Sotomayor, Sonia Soto. Once again, your hint. Her first name is Sonia. I know. That doesn't help at all. Okie dokie. 77% of you are correct. 77%. Sotomayor graduates summa cum laude from Princeton, then Yale. You know, no big deal. Just went to Princeton and then Yale. Good grief. Oh my gosh. Question 50. All of the following are true of Amelia Earhart except for one. They are super long, so I won't read them to distract you. You can read them for yourself. Go ahead. Which one is untrue? Untrue. All right. Well, that's really evenly spread out. Wow. I mean, any one of those could be correct, but the correct one is D. She was the first person to fly solo across the Pacific. Is not true. She went missing in the Pacific, actually. 50 questions in. And it's showing us Felicia is in first place. But Stephanie is, I mean, it is basically neck and neck. Out of 10,000 points, only 24 separate you two. Don't look now, but Moisey is gaining right there. Sadie Ann only 400 away. Erica and Yunsu, Valerie, you got some work to do to get on up there. We will see if you are able to. Bunny's dropping a little bit. Everyone else is kind of... Ashley, you've gotten a whole bunch right since you joined us. If you'd have joined us at the beginning of the game, you may have caused some problems. All right, everyone's looking good. Let's go for the stretch run as we head to question number 51. 51 is our next question. She was the first woman to dunk in a WNBA game. Cheryl Swoops, Lisa Leslie, Diana Taurasi, Candace Parker. That time when we just checked the leaderboard... That's the last time we look at the leaderboard. We do not again until the end of the show. This is going to cause some drama. We'll see how it goes. Do you get this question right? 73% of you do. 74% of you do. Lisa Leslie attended the University of South Carolina. 52. Just picking up the speed a little bit here. What is not true of Gal Gadot? One of these things is not true. The other three are true. These questions are now worth 600 points each. There are 10 questions between now and the end of the show. That means there are 6,000 points from here on out. If you get on a hot streak, a little bit lucky perhaps as well, you can leapfrog way up in the game. Like only a few points separates a whole bunch of you at the top, and we have 6,000 points available. 52% of you going with the correct answer. She is a celebrity endorser of Smartwater, and she was born in Israel. She did serve in the army over there, the armed forces. 53! Oh, man. Amanda Gorman, who recently spoke at the president's inauguration, won what award? The Nobel Peace Prize. The Right Livelihood Award. The National Youth Poet Laureate. The Pulitzer Prize. Talk about a girl on fire. Between the inauguration and the Super Bowl for a poet, that's like I'm interested to see where she goes from here. That's unreal. She can speak too. My goodness. As 65% of you know, because you got the correct answer. Hearing her speak and her syntax is incredible. Youngest inaugural poet in U.S. history. 54. It's getting exciting here. One fact about famed journalist Barbara Walters. Three of these are true. One of them is not. Oh, man. What's it going to be? I love this gift, too. her face. She has an epic eye roll. Anything happening on YouTube? I want to go up there and catch Felicia. Oh, come on, Danver. You can do it. You can get it. Maybe not, but you can try. Just because you start a little bit late. Other than that, I complete faith in you. 43% of you are wrong. Six people. Tanver, if you are one of them, that can help you catch Felicia. She did not interview four presidents. She interviewed nine presidents. And she was the star of the Today Show for 11 years. Incredible career. 55. In 2019, Jessica Meir and Christina Koch made history as the first all-woman spacewalk, the first woman president, vice president of a Fortune 500 company, first all-woman fighter pilot duo, first two women to graduate from West Point. This is a tough question. I don't even know what I would have guessed. Well, 57% of you got the correct answer. Not a huge majority, but it is. The spacewalk was delayed several months because NASA didn't have spacesuits designed for women. Huh. Normally at 55, we would check the answer after five questions, but no. We go all the way to the end. Question number 56. Among other achievements, Princess Diana was awarded the Nobel Peace Prize. Who did she marry? Once again, I would have struggled. Prince Edward, Prince Harry, Prince Philip, Prince Charles. I would have struggled. We're coming on down to the end. Remember, if you end up in first, second, and third, not only do you win $60 now, you come back for the national champions. 67% of you going with Prince Charles. That's a nice majority of you. Princess Diana supported the international campaign to ban landmines. She did a lot of good in her life. 57. Mary Jackson, Katherine Johnson, and Dorothy Vaughan were three African-American women who contributed greatly to NABA, NASA, BALA, or SAB. Yes, if you end up in first, second, or third, you will be coming back for the national championships, April 28th. Like I said, I think it's Yunsu, Jessica, and Sadie Ann, if I recall correctly from the show that we did for Queens last month. So the three of you are going to be there. We'll see who else will be joining you tonight. 83% of you going with NASA. That is correct. NASA, correct answer. There's a movie, Hidden Figures. Check it out. It's like 4 years ago. It's pretty great. 58 asks us, the National Women's Hall of Fame opened in 1969 in what city? I did not know this. I would have had to guess. I probably would not have guessed right, but that's just me. You, however, you can be our champion today by getting this answer correct. Come on, unanimous. No, it's not unanimous, it's late in the show. But it's pretty darn high. 83% of you going with the correct answer of Seneca Falls. Not bad, not bad. Inducts distinguished American women through a rigorous national honor selection process. Has anyone ever been there? I mean, it's in New York, right? So maybe you've been out that way. Let me know if you have. That'd be cool. I don't know anyone that has been there. 59. Two questions left. Katherine Hepburn was a Hollywood leading lady for over 60 years. Which movie was she not in? I've heard the name Katherine Hepburn. That's all. I know she was an actress. I know she was like the golden age of cinema, but I wouldn't have known this. I would not have known. Let's see if you knew. Some of you did know. It's 39% of you. Who went with To Catch a Thief? You are correct. She's originally from Hartford. Not that far from, I mean, relatively speaking. My friends, we are down to our last question. It is question 60. Then we give away $240. When did Congress expand Women's History Week to a whole month? 1911, 1946, 1979, 1987. Hey, thanks all of you for playing. Don't all go running off right afterwards, because remember, we still have the random money, so two of you will randomly win some cash. That's always a nice time. Okay. Is it 1987? Hey, look, 87% of you went for 1987. Well, isn't that a nice little tie-up of things there? And you're correct. All right, let's go and check the leaderboard. First, second, and third, taking home $60 and a place in the national championship. Drum roll, please. Here is our winners tonight. It's Felicia, Sadian, and Moisey. Edging out Stephanie there. Oh, by 200 points. Felicia, you kind of took off there. Not a bad game at all. 56. Wow. These are some good scores. Stephanie, 200 points out. Yun Su tried to make a comeback. Erica was up there for a while. So was Valerie. I think even at one point, Shayla was up there somewhere near there, right? Second over there, Jonathan, Aaron, Jiang, Shira, Gabriel, Ashley, you did well. Yeah. For when you started, absolutely. Jessica, Carly, and then a couple people who did not do quite as well. All right, fantastic. Felicia, Sadian, and Moisey, congratulations. You all are getting some money. Gabby says, hello, Moisey from Accounting 306. That's awesome. Felicia's giving a smile. Yeah, Felicia, good job. Hey, let's give away some random money, shall we? So here's what's going to happen. I'm going to hit this number three times. First time, not a winner. Second time, not a winner. Third time. Third time will be a winner. And we'll do that twice, okay? Just to build up the drama. Make that screen big again. Let's go ahead. Third one through is, oh, how many people did we end up with? Let me see. We end up with 26, but Dwayne doesn't count. So 25. 25. Tanver's ready to win some money. Third time, third number. Here we go. It is not going to be number four. Oh, at least not yet. It's random. It can always come back around to there. It's not going to be 18, but the first one goes to number 13. And number 13 is Jonathan. Jonathan, nice ending place there to take home $30. 97.76. And Bunny had 10. All right, Jonathan, there you go. Very good. All right, let's do it one more time. Again, it will be the third person. Unless it's 13, you can't win twice. But third one will be it. Not going to be 23. Not going to be 19. But it is going to be number 23. It comes back around. That's what makes it all random. Ingrid. Ingrid at 23. Way to go. You got a lucky break of 23 to 19 and back to 23 again. That is something that usually does not happen. How about that? Well, congratulations to all of the winners. Once again, thanks to JC, Kayla, and Dwayne. That is the team from Queens College that did all the hard work to put this together. Congratulations to our winner. Hey, thanks everyone for playing. I hope you had a good time. Love to see the comments on Facebook. This is good to see. Oh, Tanver, you were 24. One off. And it 23 hit twice. Wow. Oh, Felicia, I'm glad that you had a good time. That is what we'd like to see. How close were you there as well? 23. Yeah, Tanver, I mean, points. Position-wise, you were close, but points was still pretty far away. Ah, fantastic. Hey, everyone. Thank you so much. I'm going to go ahead and hop on off so I can send all of you your money if you won. Spend it nicely. I will be sending you your money from this, and then I will send you a follow-up from Jason at jasonhudi.com. That is what you can do. When can we play again? Tanver, this was our third show. I don't know if we have any more scheduled at the moment, but if we do schedule more, be sure to keep an eye on the Queens College YouTube and everything, and they'll let you know if we're going to have another show, okay? Shayna, glad you had a good time. Valerie, yeah, you're up there for a little bit there. Fantastic. Kayla does rock. That is true. Ingrid, you win some money. That's right. Dwayne says we shall see, so maybe there'll be more. You never know. If you had a good time, make sure to let student activities know. We will see you next time, everybody. Yeah, Val, you're up there for a while. It's tough, though, you know, to stay up there for 60 questions, but hopefully you had a good time. All right, everyone, I'm going to hop on. Oh, you had your hopes up. Yeah. It gets tense there at the end, doesn't it? See, now you're all talking. Now that the pressure's off. That's what we like to see. Fantastic. Oh, Ingrid enjoyed this and it improved test-taking skills. Dwayne says, yes, let's let everybody know if you want it. There you go. Just send an email to studentlife@qc.cuny.edu. Let them know you had fun with the 1660 show. Maybe we'll do another one in April. You never know. Fantastic. Thanks for putting that down. Dwayne, JC, thanks for all your hard work. Kayla, I'm not sure if Kayla's here tonight, but thanks for all the hard work you did as well. Glad everybody had fun and a good time. Tanver, keep an eye out. Maybe it'll be next time you can join us for the whole game. Ingrid, congratulations. I'm going to sign off. We'll see you next time. Goodbye, everybody.